I remember all my childhood being at the doctor and my freaking pneumonia were due to bacteria. At high school, I went to a natural science fair and I met two older students that they told me that they were like modifying bacteria for producing proteins and solve hunger in the world. And that scenario just changed my life because I didn't know the potential of bacteria. They are the most special creature on Earth because they are super powerful. They just can kill you or save you in a second. I am Patricia Aymà Maldonado, and I am a bacteria trainer. In 2018, I founded the company. We are producing a biodegradable bioplastic with bacteria that eat organic waste. I think that plastic isn't a problem itself. It's how we produce it, how we use it, and how we dispose of it. Plastic is crucial for different social, technological, and medical advancements. We use it in wherever you can think. Plastic is light, plastic is soft, plastic is flexible, and it has a very good performance that not other products can give. We need plastic. Traditionally, plastic is extracted from petrol sources. Petrol-based plastic stick around for a long time. And only 9% of the plastic in the world is recycled. 90% of the plastic is incinerated, and 50% goes to landfills. When it gets recycled, it loses quality. So it is quite important to mix it again with virgin plastic in order to have the best application of the product. When I mean virgin plastic, I mean the plastic that is extracted for the first time from this fraction of the petroleum. Data from 2023, it shows that extraction of virgin plastic has increased. So that means that we are promoting recycling and also virgin production plastic is increasing. So it is the perfect illusion of sustainability. If we do nothing, in 2050, there will be more plastic than fish in the sea. It is still growing and will continue growing if we do not change how the system is accountable on that. Because it often seems that the full responsibility falls into individuals. No matter how you try to avoid single-use plastics, no matter how you separate properly at your home, it will never be enough. A company puts a plastic product and the customer has to take care of the planet. I need that plastic. You are not giving me another solution. They have to start thinking about the future. It's time to be accountable and to substitute this type of materials for the ones that can take care of the planet. So a bioplastic is a plastic that meets one of these two conditions. It is bioplastic from its origin. That means there is no petrol-based plastic. Or it is a bioplastic for its end of life. That means that it is biodegradable or compostable. Our bioplastic is double bioplastic from its origin to its end of life. We work with agri-food companies, for example, a beer production company, and they give to us the leftover or the spent yeast from the beer production. At first stage, we have a group of bacteria that cook the waste, okay? They are like the chef, and they cook the waste so that is like really tasty. For a second stage, another one group of bacteria take that tasty waste and produce the bioplastic. And at the end, we obtain the bioplastic. This is a thing that some kind of bacteria can do. Not all the bacteria can do. And it's an adaptative survival skill. You have to ask bacteria for doing something, and she will do it. For me, bacteria is a girl, okay? So it's a super girl. We work with a system that is installed there where the waste is generated, in the customer facilities, and we start taking the waste directly into our module, our box. And that is working 24 hours a day. It is a new scenario for companies working with us. They go from managing a waste into having a real benefit, a real value, because they do not have to change machines. They have to change the mentality. Right now, we are already treating 3 tons of spent yeast in a day. We take 300 grams of spent yeast to produce 1 kilo of our bioplastic. And this is bioplastic, by the way, produced with bacteria and organic waste. So it has the same appearance and it behaves really similar. It means that it can melt, It can flow. It can enter in the machines. It can give you like a strength, you know, and you just can make the same products as petrol-based plastics. Right now, this bioplastic is already working in luxury, like the parfum, the cosmetics, healthcare, whatever you can imagine with a plastic that behaves as a petrol-based plastic, you know? If you throw the plastic away, that I don't want you to do that, by the way. I want you to separate properly. But if you do it, then we can expect that bioplastic gets to the marine environment. And maybe in 4 months, it can biodegrade in 90%, depending on the width that the bioplastic has. You cannot make microplastics with bioplastics. It is organic. It breaks naturally, like in small compounds, and is food for other bacteria, for other microorganisms. Having this bacteria right now and having our plant already functioning, working with 3 tons of organic waste a day, transforming this into bioplastic, it puts us in the first line of this marathon, this global marathon. This is a new way, a new alternative to take care of the planet. It is what I work for, and it is really worthy.